Labetalol is an alpha and beta adrenergic antagonist used to treat hypertension, angina, and sympathetic overactivity syndrome. In this video, let's find found. What is labetalol? What is labetalol used for? Contraindication. What are the side effects of taking labetalol? How does labetalol work? How to use labetalol? What is labetalol? Labetalol is a medication used to treat high blood pressure and in long-term management of angina. This includes essential hypertension, hypertensive emergencies, and hypertension of pregnancy. In essential hypertension, it is generally less preferred than a number of other blood pressure medications. It can be given by mouth or by injection into a vein. Labetalol was patented in 1966 and came into medical use in 1977. It is available as a generic medication. In 2020, it was the 210th most commonly prescribed medication in the United States, with more than 2 million prescriptions. What is labetalol used for? Labetalol injections are indicated to control blood pressure in severe hypertension. Labetalol tablets are indicated alone or in combination with antihypertensives like thiazides and loop diuretics to manage hypertension. Contraindication. Labetalol is contraindicated in people with overt cardiac failure, greater than first-degree heart block, severe bradycardia, cardiogenic shock, severe hypotension, anyone with a history of obstructive airway disease including asthma, and those with hypersensitivity to the drug. Side effects. Labetalol use can result in blurred vision or other changes in vision, chills, cold sweats, confusion, difficult or labored breathing, dizziness, faintness, or lightheadedness when getting up from lying or sitting position, shortness of breath, swelling of face, fingers, feet, or lower legs, tightness in chest, wheezing. Pharmacodynamic. Labetalol antagonizes various adrenergic receptors to decrease blood pressure. The duration of action is long, as it is generally given twice daily, and the therapeutic window is wide, as patients usually take 200 to 400 mg twice daily. Patients susceptible to bronchospasms should not use labetalol unless they are unresponsive to or intolerant of other antihypertensives. Mechanism of action. Labetalol non-selectively antagonizes beta-adrenergic receptors and selectively antagonizes alpha-1 adrenergic receptors. Following oral administration, labetalol has 3 times the beta-blocking ability than alpha-blocking ability. This increases to 6.9 times following intravenous administration. Antagonism of alpha-1 adrenergic receptors leads to vasodilation and decreased vascular resistance. This leads to a decrease in blood pressure that is most pronounced while standing. Antagonism of beta-1 adrenergic receptors leads to a slight decrease in heart rate. Antagonism of beta-2 adrenergic receptors leads to some of the side effects of labetalol, such as bronchospasms. However, this may be slightly attenuated by alpha-1 adrenergic antagonism. Labetalol leads to sustained vasodilation over the long term without a significant decrease in cardiac output or stroke volume, and a minimal decrease in heart rate. Half-life. Labetalol has a half-life of 1.7 to 6.1 hours. Dose. The dose of this medicine will be different for different patients. Hypertension. 100 mg POQ12HR initially, increased by 100 mg Q12HR every 2 to 3 days. Usual dosage range, 200 to 400 mg POQ12HR, not to exceed 2,400 mg per day. Hypertensive emergency. 20 mg 4 over 2 minutes initially, then 40 to 80 mg 4Q10 minutes. Total dose not to exceed 300 mg. Alternative, 1 to 2 mg/min by continuous 4 infusion, total dose of 300 mg has been used. Safety advice. Accompanying texts should be consulted for further details. U.S. FDA Pregnancy Category C. Animal reproduction studies have shown an adverse effect on the fetus, and there are no adequate and well-controlled studies in humans, but potential benefits may warrant use of the drug in pregnant women despite potential risks. That's all the information about labetalol we collected. Thanks for listening. Do not forget to like, share, and subscribe for the HeInfo channel if you like this video to update more health information.